I follow my dreams. You'd think they were nightmares the way they scream. I make them believe.
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we've got the Akame Kill Volume 12. The story is by Takahiro and the art is by Tetsuna Tashiro. So this, as you can see, is the front cover. We have a bright yellow with Lionel on top. Lionel, however you pronounce her name. She is the front of this manga today. And also, like I said in the previous two, this is German. So obviously I don't read the books. If it's not in the right English, I don't actually read it. I just read it by the pictures, which kind of does do a lot of understanding. And if you don't believe me, here's the gem net. So, look at this, and the translation at the back, it says, two women, one man, the fight between the saddest F-death, and the devil mind is becoming increasingly devastating. That one, Tatsumi got hurt because this guy who looks like, All Might, in offense, he does look like All Might in this. Tatsumi was fighting him, and basically he got a hit on her, and then he ends up falling, getting himself injured. Then Mine takes over and does a shot, and she gets herself really severely injured. But then she turns out to be fine, just but lovely. And okay, the two Furies don't give each other anything while they lay everything around them to rubble and ashes. Driven to by desire to free Tatsumi, Mine gives everything. Her opponent, Ezra Death, on the other hand, has a morbid desire. She wants to fight with the right to kill Tatsumi with her own hands. So she now knows who he is and what he's a part of. She wants to kill him by her own hands, even though she's supposed to love him. It is very confusing. But Mine does not want that, so I'm guessing Mine, we know that Mine loves Tatsumi, and I think Tatsumi is falling in love with her, with Mine, or is in love with her. I am not sure how it goes with that, but okay. The Alice girl was kind of in there, and she sends out this massive bug creature, and this creature is massive and it's disgusting, and it's like laying its eggs places, and then it turns something else. Lionel defeats that girl because she's such an ass. With a big boulder, she finally got it on the floor, and then took this big boulder and she just crushed her with it. And I was like, oh damn, you don't pee off them. No. But it's like the storylines. This girl here, she gets herself killed. I'm putting the Alice girl because he does really like the Alice girl. Yeah, see? That guy really reminds me of All Might. Anyway, so that is volume 3. As you've seen from the last video, I was doing mangas into one video to make it more easier. Volume 13 and 14 will be with this one as well. So if you bear with me 1 second, you guys will see volume 13 in just a moment. So 1 second. Okay guys, we're back with the volume 13. So as you can see in the front, this is the picture of Akame's sister. I totally forgot her name. Kurame. I don't know. I can't pronounce her name. So this one's mainly about her and her sister and stuff like that. So this is definitely intriguing. This is an orange colour font, as you can see, and then if I turn it around, it is more orange. So in German, I will translate that. It says that blood is thicker than water, but the love-hate relationship between Akame and Kurame's siblings takes on the sub traits. The two sisters have sworn to kill each other. They come to that, but the guy who also transforms into like Tatsumi, that suit, we all know that he fell in love with Kurame, with her, at the end she ends up kissing him anyway, and she doesn't want him to get hurt. So at the end, when they're fighting with Akame, they realise that they don't. What's the point of being hurting when they could just live a normal life? To be honest, she doesn't want to get him hurt. He doesn't want her to get hurt. They just want to live a normal life, I believe. That's what the picture looks like it's telling me. So, while Tatsumi gradually realises how important this life and death struggles is to Akame, doubts grow with Kurama's companion, Wave. Oh, that's his name, Wave. Yeah, Wave gets some feelings for him and blah blah. He does not want to see his comrade die and is determined to stand between the two opponents even if it costs his life. But she doesn't want that. She doesn't want Wave to die. She has feelings for him, that's why she kisses him, and a lot does happen in this. It's very different to see how it all does turn out, and it's really interesting to see something like this. You know, you don't really expect it, but you know you do. So, this one's not really much to say, it's just about the sisters trying to live to fight, but Kanami does cry in this because she sees that she doesn't want to hurt their sister. Pretty much, that's how it is. I'm not going to say anything else about that one. Like I said, I'm not trying to spoil too much. Volume 14 is up next. I hope you guys enjoyed that, and I will see you in a second. Bye. Okay, back for the volume 14. So, as you can see in the front, it is Tatsumi with the armor. I can't remember what the armor is called for some reason. It's been like a while since I last read the first 8 volumes. So they've gone through a lot of things in their life, and they're getting rid of their battle pretty much. So let's get more in details in a second. As you see, the front cover is like this kind of a red colour. And there we go, in red. Translation to the back is that the time is ripe for the decisive battle. Tatsumi, Leono, Akame, Najinda go into battle one last time. So they get ready to go to battle and to fight Ezra Death, even though she has got these people who are monsters, who are creatures. This minister who killed the prince's only parents, their parents were dead, right? He killed them so he can punish him, the prince, and make him more angry, make him more do more stuff. And then he unleashed this big, massive robot thing. And holy crap. Ships down the swan. Good, last time. To take the Imperial City to help the rebel army. Now the camps face each other, Ezra fulfills her new trump card, an army of hundreds of ice soldiers that she can recreate over and over again. Well, yeah, because she has the power of ice. That's not fair. Unfortunately, their new tricks are not the only ace the minister leaves asleep. The highest trump has not even been played yet. So that's with the prince. Or the king now, shall I say, because his parents were killed. Doesn't look like it, they look like there were accidents, but the minister killed them by the looks of it, because the way he was very happy that he unleashed the prince's anger. Stuff like that. Eesh. That's creepy down the spine there, doesn't it? So there we go, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this. What am I saying? So yeah, big battle happens. It's literally just a big battle between everyone getting ready to fight against each other. That's pretty much it. We got one more volume, but that volume is actually going to be on its own. It's not going to be marked with anyone else. It's going to be on its own because Zero is going to be up next. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and it's not really much, but there you go. Volume 14, 15 is up next. I hope I'll see you next time, and bye bye for now.